homelessness, to me, I mean, homelessness is, I don't know, it ain't something that you grow up and want to pursue as a career. It happened to a whole rack of people. And I'm just coming back to Washington, D.C. in 2005. And I can remember it was July. And I can remember getting a newspaper, like about the 8th. And in the newspaper, it was an article in there that really shocked me. And it was talking about homelessness. And it says, in the Washington metropolitan area, that we'll be surprised how many people is one paycheck away from being homeless. People who have houses, pay mortgages, people who's renting, the people who live with people. Me, myself, I didn't pick homelessness. I'm gonna just say homelessness picked me.
You know, I had a room, then I lost my place. And then I started sleeping out here on the street. I'm like the black sheep in my family. I made mistakes. You know, now I'm homeless on the street, still trying to survive. Alcohol and narcotics. I started when I was 19. My friends taught me how to smoke a cigarette. As soon as I smoked my first cigarette, then it went to marijuana. Dealing with the PCP, crack, heroin, you know, back in the days, in the 90s. Then I went in 96. Then the 11 years came out. So it was a rough journey, but it wasn't really that hard.
You know, it does. There are less jobs available now. Now, that really doesn't affect me very much. However, I don't even look for jobs anymore, right? So that applies to there not being jobs in the context that even if there were jobs and I was looking, I wouldn't be able to find them. I'm sandwiched in a place where I just can't acquire an income, so I'm stationary in a non-moving position.
The community help churches, get you clothes, feed you. You know, they help you out a lot. Community help you out a lot in D.C.
And Friendship Place has helped you too?
Yes. Friendship have out underwears, clothes, you know, change underwears, clothes, health. When they got doctors back there, you know, to help you out.
Presbyterian Church, thanks for supporting. James Madison University, thank you for watching and supporting us. Ooh, the French International School is supporting. How many internationals in the house? Supporting, okay, Charlie.
We have got a GOP. Get together! Community of Hope! office, please.
Becoming homelessness. Thank you.
Hello. Shout out to the IMF.
Hopefully what we can do can help them to improve their living and help them to find a way out.
Okay. And when you see a homeless person on the street, what do you do usually?
I feel sorry for them, but majority of the time you just walk away because it's kind of something you don't know what to do. Especially when you work for your all, you know, yourself, it's pretty hard.
What's your name?
James.
And are you happy that today people are walking for homelessness?
Yes, because they can money to go towards the food and help people, homeless people out in the streets.
To the Purcell family.
Volunteer their time, if they can't volunteer their time, to donate food or money or medical supplies, just get more involved.
Do you do that yourself? Do you like?
Yes.
So if you see a homeless person on the street, do you give them a dollar or a sandwich? Or?
Usually I'll give them money because usually not near a store or something like that. There have been times when we've invited them to food. My children and I have donated our time and had bags of food and things like that for the needy.
I'm going to say this. I can look and I can point fingers and I can say, well, if they do this, if they do that, if they do all the community can do is get more benefit of the doubt and just give people more chances. As far as I ain't talking about build places for them to live free. Nah. What I mean, give them more opportunities to be able to have a job. You know what I mean? To save up some money. Have more programs where a person can build up their self-esteem. You know what I mean? To get to the mindset that I'm in. You know what I mean? But far as just giving, that's not going to help. You know what I mean? It's an old saying. What would be more profitable? To give me a fish that I eat just that day or teach me how to fish that I eat a lifetime? I truly believe teach me how to fish that I be able to eat a lifetime. You know what I mean? Nothing else, because you know what I mean, just giving. I think that's more detrimental to the person who's giving, because let me get him on my way, let me give him this, let me give him that. You're making the disease more worse.
That's all. That's the name of the game. You got to survive. The name of the game is survive. That's it. When you're on the street, you got to survive. Everything coming at you.
Is there any violence that you endure outside?
Violence? It'd be a whole lot of violence. You might get drunk and start fighting for life. It's a whole lot of violence on the street.
Your goals. What are your dreams? That's what I want to know.
My dreams is to get me a nice house. And have me a dog, a couple of dogs running around. A wife and you know, a family, some kids. You know, that's my goal.
So what are the steps that you're hoping to take towards that goal?
I don't know if it's going to be here in D.C., it might be out of Maryland. Or what. I play it by ear because I never know what the next day going to come. Right now I'm in a rough, right now I'm in my bad stages. But I bounce back. I always do. I do bad for a minute and then I be back on top. That's how I do.
Very very educated. I mean, but this thing homeless, it's like a disease. I guess like addiction. I didn't choose it, it chose me. And I just had to deal with it. But there is a cure for it. And the cure to me, I believe, is being productive. You know what I mean? Being responsible. You know what I mean? Paying your rent. You know what I mean? Not writing bad checks. You know what I mean? Having good rental history. You know what I mean? Doing the right thing. That's the cure. Because you never know. In a blink of an eye. I done met some people that was just like I was, but a little better. And in a blink of an eye, we went from park place to park bench. And believe me, that's something to squall on.